alone, here on your own, glued to your phone. Never would have left you alone for someone else to take you home. I could be a better boyfriend than him. I could do the shit that he never did. Up all night, I won't quit. I'm gonna steal you from him. I could be such a gentleman. Plus, you know my clothes would fit. I could be a better boyfriend than him. I could do the shit that he never did. Up all night, I won't quit. Thinking I'm gonna steal you from him. I could be such a gentleman. Plus, all my clothes would fit. I can't believe we're finally alone. I can't believe.
Hello, my loves, and welcome back to Studio Soli Luna. Today we're going to be dancing to the song Boyfriend by Dove Cameron. This is a very sexy, very flirty, very teasing song. So of course we're doing burlesque, and I'm so excited because this routine is a lot of just like feel good moves that really connect to the music. And so when you dance it in a way that you're connecting to the performance, to the music, to your body, it just feels so, so good. Also, if you didn't know already, I have open spots for my next round of CHM, Confidence, the Heels Method, and I would absolutely love to have you be part of this program. It's a heel and burlesque program focusing on self-love, building confidence, and really having the ability and the capability to go after anything that you want in your life, whether that is on the dance floor or off the dance floor. So I would love to have you join us and learn more about this program. Click the link below in the description to book a call with me and see if this program is the right fit for you. With that being said, go ahead, grab your heels, grab your knee pads if you need them, and we will get right into this combo. All right, my loves, if you're ready, let's get into this combo, okay? So we actually start on the floor. The whole entire first part out of two parts is on the floor. The second half is standing up. So go ahead and start down on the ground. And this piece is very much a conversation. I feel like so many of my pieces, I feel like dance is a conversation in general, but this one specifically, she's saying, I can be a better boyfriend than him, I can do what he can't, that kind of thing. So I really want it to be like this teasing, playful conversation with someone, okay? So I'm sitting to begin like I'm having a conversation with someone. My knees are bent and I've got my left hand propped up on my face, and I'm just kind of moving from side to side. Yeah, so you see me in the beginning, I'm kind of just like moving back and forth, however you want to get started. But you want to end facing the right, so your head is looking right. When she starts, I can be a better boyfriend, we look, I can. So it's like this slow look, be a better boyfriend. So on that moment, we go ka. So we open the legs, we're arching the back, making sure that you're really lifting up through the chest here. And you take the left hand up the body, around the head to hair whip to the left and close the legs. Yes. So that's kind of all one motion except for the look to the front at the beginning. Everything else is very much together. So starting from the top, we go 5, 6, 7, we look slow, we slap open, 2, 3, making sure you have pointed toes and a wide hand here. You take it around the left side of the head, circle, and then I put my hand back down to hair whip to close. When I close, I'm looking to my left. Boom. From here, we're going to do a little leg lift, but the way that I really get a lot of extension on this leg lift is by lifting my left hip up off the ground. So if I just tried to do it like this, it's like not as cute because my back is rounded. But if instead I lift that left booty cheek off the ground and then open, it gives it a little bit more lift and your leg can get higher, yeah? So we're here, we close. I'm opening up to the right as I lift my left booty cheek, and I continue until we get to the opposite side. I bring my legs together and then I'm going to hair whip. Better scoot away from the wall. I'm going to hair whip whoom, to this like Little Mermaid upward dog position, okay? So So let's go over that transition again. So we just did this little leg extension open, and we bring everything together, and then we're going to hair whip to the back. And try not to damage your plant. My sweet little leaf. He goes through so much over here. So yes, when you do that hair whip, it's going to help your momentum to whip you to the back. If you don't do it, it might feel a little bit harder. So that's why it's there. Also, hair whips just look really sexy. So that's why as well. Okay, let's do all of that from the top. All right, my loves, starting from the top. 5, 6, 7, we look slow. We slap. When I slap, I do a little hair to the side just to kind of make that moment big, but that's up to you. So we go open, 2, 3, hand around the head, we hair whip, and we close, close. From here, we put both hands behind us to lift the leg and open, drop the booty, bring the legs together, we hair whip into this upward dog position. Okay. From here, after we land, we're going to do a little prep back. That little prep back is just to match the timing, but I really want you to like pop into it, okay? After we pop back, we're gonna do a 1, 2, 3. Yes, like a little quick cat-cow. So we're gonna go open, close, open. Yes. So you come from here, we go ta, 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 and then we have a hair whip to the front before we dive to the floor. Okay, so those are quick, which means you wanna like really get into it, yeah? So make sure that your core is engaged, you're not just like releasing pressure into your low back. And also, you're like really using your booty to go ta, ta, ta. Yeah, a lot of it's here in my booty slash top of the hips. So you go ta, 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 we hair whip to the front, which initiates this dive. I'm taking my head to the ground first, and then my knees are sliding back, back, back. So what the legs do at that moment is when we go tap, 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 and hair whip, my feet actually stay up, 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 up. Sorry, it's hard to do slow, until the last moment, and then they release. Yeah? So you're diving your body, 1, 2, 3, and then the feet go tap. Yes. Okay, so it's like you're doing this little snake with your head. Your feet are staying up until the last moment, and then they click to the floor on this little click in the music, okay? So we dive head first. 1, 2, 3, we click, and then we roll to the back onto our backs. Yes. From here, to finish this little piece, we are going to do, she says close would fit. So we're gonna do a little close would fit. And that's a little press up, drop it down, press up with the booty. Instead of just going lift and lift, I'm going close, open, close. It gives it a little bit more of this like intense energy because it's a really intense moment in the song. So go tap, tap, tap. Good. From here, we drop the booty and we bring the chest and the body up first into my goddess rising. You've done this a lot with me if you've taken my heels classes. The chest is coming first. Toes are pointed for the goddesses and my hands are pulling me up as my head comes last. Yes. Okay, let's take all of that back from where we did the leg extension, and then we'll go until there, okay? So what we did is we extended the right leg up to open, we closed the legs, we hair whip to all fours. Yes, we pressed it back to go ta, ta, ta. We hair whip to dive, dive, and ta with the legs at the same time. We roll to the back. From here, I take my hands down to go 1, 2, 3. And this is when we come into our goddess rising. 1, 2, 3. Yes. And wherever your hands need to be on that moment to pull your body up, that's totally fine. Okay. Let's just finish this last move, because it's the last move on the floor, and then we'll put it all together from the top. So after we just pulled ourselves up, we just did 1, 2, 3. Make sure you're really engaging everything here and getting as high as you can. Ta, ta, ta. You drop it down. We pull it up into our goddess rising. 1, 2, 3. Head comes last. From here to finish on the floor, we are doing a little magic mic move. And I say that it's like a little body roll with the legs, yeah? So a full body roll, but for some reason it reminds me of Magic Mike. So you just came up, we should end here. We're going to come up like this, and we're going to take the legs out and in. Yes, so 1, 2. It's like you're rolling everything out. I'm coming up on my toes to get the highest elevation possible, but you don't have to. You can just stay more on this like reverse tabletop, or you can come up onto your toes to take it out and in. Yes, so I'm taking it out and in. Before I drop my booty, I'm gonna use my body to propel me forward to go ta-ta. Yes. Okay, and then that is how we get up off of the floor. So, after we just did, we came up from our goddess rising, we come up from here, we go body roll, and you see how my hips are going back, and then I go tap tap. It's not the cutest. I'm using my hands to like push me forward, but if your momentum's there, nobody's gonna be paying attention to what your hands are doing. So you're here, you're gonna roll, and you're gonna go left, right. Yes, cool. Okay, let's take that again from the bridge, and then we'll add it on to the very top. So we just did, we go lift and lift, drop, you take it, goddess rising, 2, 3. We do a body roll to go left, right. And then you should end in this little sexy squat position, making sure you've got a really nice arch in your spine, booty is tooched out, boom, boom. Yes. And then from here, we're just gonna press onto the thighs to standing. Okay, so after you just did tap, tap, we go press, booty comes first, 2, 3. And then we are standing, okay? So let's go ahead and take all of that from the top really, really slowly. I'll try to give you some lyrics and then we'll do it with music twice. All right, my loves, taking everything from the top, looking to the right. We go 5, 6, 7. We look, I can be a better boyfriend than him. Around the head, I can do the shit that he never, this leg lift is on, did. Bow, bow, we close here. Think I could steal you from here with him. We lay the head down, and I could be such a gentleman. This slide is on gentleman. Click. You'll hear those clicks the whole time in the music. We roll to the back. Plus, all my clothes would fit. We bring it up. I can be a better boyfriend. This is on him. I can do the shit that he never did. Press. Up, 2, 3. Yes, so juicy. I love this combo, and hopefully doing it like that gives you a better idea of where things are to the lyrics, because I've choreographed almost entirely to the lyrics of this song. But the cool thing about burlesque is that sometimes it's more about the feeling than about the timing and it being super structured. So I want you to really feel into it, but if something does hit on a word, I want you to try and make sure you hit it on that word. Okay, all right, let's do it from the top twice with music. Really get this first half into your body, and then we'll finish the second half together.
You're on your own, glued to your phone. Never would have left you alone for someone else to take you home. I could be a better boyfriend than him. I could do the shit that he never did. Up all night, I won't quit. I'm gonna steal you from him. could be such a gentleman. Plus, you know my clothes would fit. I could be a better boyfriend than him. I could do the shit that he never did. Go to your phone. Never would have left you alone for someone else to take you home. I could be a better boyfriend than him. I could do the shit that he never did. Up all night, I won't quit. I'm gonna steal you from him. I could be such a gentleman. Plus, you know my clothes would fit. I could be a better boyfriend than him. I could do the shit that he never did.
Amazing job, my loves. I hope that first and second round went super well for you and you're starting to really get the music into your body. I love starting to add music to my movements because it changes how you dance it. It changes how you perform it. When you're given steps, it's kind of like, oh, this is cute. But then when you put music with it, it's like, damn, this is feeling good. And that's exactly what I want, okay? So let's walk everything from the top really slowly, clarifying anything that we need to, and we'll finish part two. So starting on the ground, looking over to our right, we go 5, 6, 7, slow look, making sure that the look is super intentional here. Slow look, we open boyfriend, then him around the head, here whip, let that carry, your feet close. We lift up slowly, open to bring the feet together, here whip. Yes, we press back to go ta, ta, ta. We here whip to the front, which carries us into our dive. Feet come down last, click, good. We roll onto our backs here to go 1, 2, 3, and bring it up, 2, 3. We body roll, and to press 1, 2, up, 2, 3. Amazing job. So hopefully everything feels really good up until that point. From here, we are pressing up off the thighs. So we just went tap, tap, boom, 2, 3. We're going to step left, and then we're gonna have a little run, run step. So you wanna take smaller steps there so it's not huge, or you can, I don't know. I had one of my friends take this class with me and she took these gorgeous long steps. And it looked great as well, so your preference. But I go walk, ta, ta, and then I'm stepping out to the side with my right leg to do a little lasso whip. My hips go around to the right. My lasso is in my left hand. Yes, yes, yes. Everyone likes a good lasso moment. So we just did left, right, left. I'm really bent on those last ones. So the first one is like tall and long. The second one is tap, tap, really small, jazzy steps. I step out to the side to whip it around, and then I'm gonna do a body roll to sit. Yes, coming into this classic heels position that we do all the time in heels and burlesque, yes? So I just take my hands up, head goes up, body roll down, to do a hair whip up. Yes. Again, super classic move. If you've never taken my classes before, the key to this move is putting all of your weight into that bent leg booty cheek, okay? Because if my legs are like, or if my weight is too forward in my toes, I'm gonna fall when I try to do the hair whip, okay? So I'm gonna make sure I'm putting all of my weight back into my heels and that I'm using that booty cheek and the thighs squeezing together to keep me really stable, as well as the core, of course. So, one more time. We just pressed it up. We step left, right, left. We lasso to the side. We finish body roll, sit. We here whip around. From here, she says, gentlemen. We're gonna go, gentlemen. Yes. So a little tap, tap. And then we are going to step onto the right foot, transfer the weight, and do a spiral turn to the back. Okay, so again, after we just came up from our hair whip, we do a little ta-ta moment, and I take my head over my left shoulder. Gentlemen, it's like a little little comical moment. Gentlemen, we transfer the weight. I use this left arm to turn me around. And as you can see, if you watch my feet, my left leg is coming into this cross position. So I end with my left leg here. How I do that, I bring that leg in a little bit, and when I turn my body, I leave it. Instead of letting it follow me, I leave my leg stuck to the ground. Yes. So we just did, gentlemen, we use that arm to turn, boom, squeeze the legs. We're gonna do a little step out with the left foot to go into our sexy squat. And then she says, close with fit to finish. We're gonna go close with fit. Yes, we're finishing with some booty pops. We go ta, ta, ta. Yeah, so we go up, down, up. Yes, and that is the end of the routine. So after we do that, close with fit, I just want you to make your way up and walk off like a baddie, the baddie that you are, okay? So let's review all of that again from gentlemen, and then we'll add on to the second half, okay? So we just did here, facing the front. We go, gentlemen, step, use your body weight to turn into your spiral turn. From here, just to get out of this, I'm stepping forward with that front foot, and then I'm stepping to the side with my right to take it down. Yes, so watch that one more time. After I turn, I go tap, tap. And it's pretty quick, so you have to step out of your spiral with that left foot pretty quick. Here, to go one and two, I just close it, bring it up, and walk away. Yes? One more time, just like that, to make sure we have the spiral, and then we'll put it on. So we just did, gentlemen, here, boom, plus all my clothes would fit, yes? And the key to a booty pop, first of all, I'm lifting my booty off of my heels, tap, and I'm acting like I have a little ball on the back of my booty, and I'm trying to throw that ball up and over my head. Tap, tap, tap. Yes, one more time. Tap, tap, tap. We close. Yes. Amazing. That ending is just like super spicy, feels so good, and everyone in the crowd is gonna go wild, even if you're just at home by yourself. Still such a good way to end the routine. So let's go back from where we come up off the floor to the ending, and then we'll walk everything from the top really slowly. All right, my loves, we just pressed off the thighs to come up, booty comes first, and lift. We walk slow, quick, quick. We whip around, hips go with it. We body roll to sit. We take a hair whip, making sure you're putting all of your weight into that left booty cheek, cheek, cheek. From here, you're gonna go tap, tap, step, spiral turn, to go step down, down, and booty, booty, and up, two, three, to walk. Yes, amazing job, babes. Okay, let's go ahead. Take all of it really slowly from the top with one more run through, and then we're going to do it with music twice again before we go. Also, something I really want you to think about is how important the character is for this dance. The moves are maybe moves that you've seen before in burlesque class, or maybe you've seen a lot in different videos, but the difference is how you interpret them and how you put your energy and your performance into it. Like, who are you talking to? Who are you when you're dancing this routine? I like to embody, we talk about this in confidence, but I like to embody what's called our Sasha Fierce, Beyonce's alter ego. We all can step into an alter ego, an alternate version of ourselves that maybe it's not who we are on a day-to-day, but it's who we like would love to embody sometimes. Gives us a little bit more confidence, it lets us kind of let loose a little bit more and not worry so much about like how it looks on the outside, it's more about how it feels on the inside. So I really want you to tap into maybe this like alter ego version of yourself for this routine specifically. I feel like it really calls for that. And you'll really be surprised how it shifts how your dancing looks when you feel really good inside doing it. So thinking about that as we come to a close in this class. So starting from the top, as we look to the side, we go 5, 6, 7. Slow look to open, open, around, here whip to close. Extend the left and bring the feet together, hair whip to all fours. We press it back to go ta, 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 hair whip to dive, dive, and drop the legs. We roll to the back to go 1 and 2. Bring it up into your goddess rising, 2, 3, into your body roll. Swing it back to go ta, ta. We press it up, booty first, and up we walk slow, quick, quick, to whip, to body roll, drop it down. We hear whip around to go tap, tap, step, turn, step, down, and booty, booty, to walk off the floor. All right, my loves, amazing job. I have enjoyed dancing with you so, so much today, and we are going to run it 2 times with music. The first time, I really want you to focus on just the choreography, really getting it into your body, making sure you know the moves. The second time, I want you to focus on the musicality and the performance and really how you connect to the piece, okay? It's so important, and I just know it'll change your dancing so much when you do that. And I know it's really easy to dance from the mind sometimes, but it's really important to dance from the heart as well. So let's do it with music twice all the way through. You've got this. I believe in you, and I will see you on the other side.
On your own, glued to your phone, never would have left you alone for someone else to take you home. I could be a better boyfriend than him. I could do the shit that he never did. Up all night, I won't quit. I'm gonna steal you from him. I could be such a gentleman. Plus, you know my clothes would fit. I could be a better boyfriend than him. I could do the shit that he never did. Up all night, I won't quit. Thinking I'm gonna steal you from him. I could be such a gentleman. Plus, all my clothes would fit.
Amazing job, my loves. I know you absolutely slayed that round, and I would love to see your videos. Make sure to tag me on Instagram at Ashlyn Torrey or at Studio Soleil Luna. That way I can cheer you on and support you on your dance journey. And if you like this video, make sure to give it a like below. Subscribe to my channel, that way that you never miss a video from Studio Soleil Luna. And if you are interested in joining us this round of CHM, of Confidence, then click the link below to learn more about this incredible program. It is truly life-changing, and I would love to get to chat with you more about it. I love you, babes, to the moon and back, and I will see you in the next class.